SOPs in the form of flowchart. We have tried to make it easy to understand and smooth handling of all such cases and clarity of roles of all staffs and doctors and provide comprehensive services. First of all, we are doctors and our priorities and our duties and our responsibilities are treatment of the patient. So, if the survivors brought by police or brought by relatives or herself, it should be treated on the priority basis. Then, if he or she wants to inform police, informed consent, and if she does not want to inform police, get informed refusal, get information to the police, giving permission to the police, and take consent. Take consent for every steps for medical examination and treatment, for medical examination, for sample collection, or for clinical and forensic purpose. If the survivor is less than 12 years or unconscious or intoxicated, get consent from guardians or police or MS in that orders. If the survivor is more than 12 years, can give consent herself. Taking history in own words or her own language, further examination and evidence collection in accordance with the alleged history. Take history in a separate room. Don't be judgmental. Ensure confidentiality. Make comfortable. Collect complete history. Now medical examination. Done by any registered medical practitioners, preferably female doctors. If unavailable, male doctors can do in presence of a female attendant in a separate room. Genealogical examination of any injuries, a present, local examination of genitalia and other orifices. Age exhibition if required. By police, examination by dental, physical and radiological examination. Now, evidence collection. Based on history, ask the survivor to undress herself on a white sheet. Don't do two finger test or PV. On genital examination, if required, pubic hair, pressure pubic hair, nasal swab, smears, any lubricant or condoms. On body, on examination of body, clothing and napkins, nail clipping, hairs, stand over clothes and bodies, or examination of oral and anal swabs. Now treatment. And all evidence should be packed, sealed, duly signed, sealed properly in a separate envelope. And it must be dried, air-dried, not in direct in sunlight. Don't insist upon admission unless required. Provision of opinion should be done immediately after examination and handed over to the police officers and discharged, now discharged. And then rehabilitation, post-exposure prophylaxis of HIV, hepatitis B, counseling, pregnancy, emergency contraceptions, STI treatment, and psychological assistance, then follow-up. Thank you.